Okay, today we're talking about the Anly Timer. The Anly Timer is a very popular timing device used in electrical panels. This particular type, I mean the one here, is for 220 volt AC. Okay, there are actually different types. You can have the one for AC, just as you have here. You can also have the one for DC. You can have for instance 12 volt DC or 24 volt DC. Okay, now the knob up here is for the adjustments, you know, for you to be able to select the time. This particular one has a maximum setting of 30 seconds. Okay, 30 seconds maximum. You can also have the one for up to 60 seconds, which is 1 minute really. Now on the side, you can see the diagram how to, you know, connect it. Now this diagram actually tells a story. It shows that there are two distinct circuits inside. That is, it has two relays inside that can be used to control two different circuits. Here on the left you have a relay, and there on the right you have another relay. Now although both of them are relays, there are different indications on each of them. Here you have a direct line linking two of the contacts together, and here you have, you know, a V. You can see there's a line and then a V. Now what that means is that the one on the left, the relay on the left, is a direct relay. Okay, once you push the power button, or once you supply power to the timer, that activates immediately. Now the one on the right with the V stands for variable timing. In other words, that's the timed version. Okay, whatever settings you do on the knob, you know, whatever timing duration you pick from here applies to this one, this relay, the one on the right. Okay, that's why you have a V there, variable. Okay, so basically you have these two relays that are able to control two separate circuits, and then you can see the pinouts, you can see the pin numbers on each of them. Now here at the bottom you have the base. Okay, the timer itself has pinouts that are numbered. As you can see, I can see pin 3, pin 2, pin 1, pin 8, and so on and so forth. Now here, the pins are also numbered accordingly. Okay, here I have, this one is 1, and then 2 there, 3 here, 4, 5, 6, okay, and then down here I have 7 and 8. Okay, so that means each pin here on the timer has a designated slot to go into, which corresponds to this output terminals. Okay, so now when you are trying to connect the timer with the base, when you're trying to push it in, there is a particular way you must push it in, because here you can see a notch. Okay, there's a notch down there, you know, that circle, that hole is, you know, is having a notch down here. So if for any reason you are trying to push, and up here too you can see there's a bar on the side of that pillar, there's a bar. So if you made a mistake and you're trying to push the timer in the wrong way, it will never go in. It won't, no matter how hard you try, it will not go in, except you turn it the right way. Okay, and then of course it can easily go in. All right, once you push it down, it stays connected. Okay, so now talking about the base, because the secret to being able to successfully use the timer, the secret lies in understanding this base. Okay, so we're gonna move over to the drawing that illustrates how the base works. Now here I have a sketch, okay, of my base. Now as I said earlier, there's a notch, okay, and that represents the notch, this one here. Okay, now inside of the timer, there are two relays. On the sketch here, those two relays have been represented by this imaginary line dividing the base into two sections. Okay, so here I have the timed section, that is this area comprising pin 6, 5, and 8. Okay, those are the connections for the relay, common, NO, and NC. Okay, common, normally open, and normally connected. So these three make up the timed section or timed relay. On the other side, I have pin 3, pin 4, and pin 1 comprising the second relay, which is the direct relay. Once you connect power, it activates immediately. Okay, now I have these other two pins, pin 2 and pin 8, pin 7, designated to power, that is to powering up the the timer itself. As you can see here, source represents power or input. Okay, so here I have live or positive, then there I have neutral or negative. Now why do I have the two of them? I'm supposed to have only one. It's either live or positive, negative or neutral. Now I'm having the two just for illustrative purposes. Okay, because my current timer, this particular timer, is AC, so we'll be dealing with live and neutral for pin 7 and pin 8. Okay, that's the power source. Okay, that's what you connect your power cable to. Now if you have a DC timer instead, okay, DC, maybe 12 volt DC or 24 volts, you still use the same terminals, pin 7 and 2. Okay, but in this case it will be positive and negative you are connecting, not live and neutral. Okay, all right, so I believe you understand how the base is wired now, internally configured. Okay, so that there's no confusion. Okay, now anytime you handle or pick up your Anly with the base configuration in mind, you can almost wire this even in your sleep, because the configuration is so easy to understand. NC, NC, NO, NO. So if you master how the layout is for one side, you can mirror it on the other side. It's just like an exact image of the other side, okay? As you can see, it's so easy to master, all right? The notch represents the lower side, okay? Where you have the power, okay? So if you master this layout, then you can wire your timer anywhere, anytime. And now on this side you have your the relay illustration. That's for the coil, and these are for the contacts, NO, NC, and common. Now NC means normally connected, NO means normally open, common means common, that is it is common to, just as you have here, it's like a wiper. I can contact with this or move up and contact with that. That's why they call it common. Okay, so now we're going into an actual connection, you know, to see how the timer works.